Now we're going to cut churidar bazu. These have been requested by Farah over the last quite a few weeks, and I've not actually had time to do these. But with this particular dress, I've decided to do churidar bazu, and the way I'm going to cut these is, this is a 45 inch fabric, and what I've done is just angled this off. So this is the width and the length of the fabric, and basically what we're going to do is cut the two bazu separately. So the first one, this is to stop the wastage of the fabric. The bazu themselves are quite lengthy. You can make these as lengthy as as you want. I'm going to make these, they're normally quite fitted, so what we'll do is we will leave these about a yard in length, and at the bottom point of the yard, this is where the bottom, the good thing about churidar bazu is that they can be very, very long, and they gather up because they're cut on a bias, they will gather up. The bad thing about the churidar bazu is if you live in a warm country, then I wouldn't advise making these for summer, although for winter they are ideal. So they're going to be very, very tight, and they are just cut on a tube-like cut. Armhole, the armhole cut is, I've started off, this is a full yard, and at the tip of the yard, I've marked off for the cap, and then leave the cap about 3.5-4 inches, and after that, you are going down into, and angling this out at the point of about 5.5-6 inches down. So the point here is approximately 6 inches. The bicep area is about 6 inches. This depends entirely on your own measurements. If you are quite heavy on the arm here, then preferably you would leave that slightly larger. So now, many a times I've not done most of this stuff that I do, and but by trialing it out, it gives us a chance, you guys the chance, to actually see what the result looks like, and whether it's ideal for you and whether you want to implement it or not. So you will see, hopefully you will see the result of this, of me wearing this outfit, and you can decide for yourself whether is ideal for you or not. Now the second of the sleeves, this is also the bias leftover cut that we've got, fabric that we've got, and what we're going to do is layer the fabric on top of that sleeve and cut the second of the sleeves. Obviously this, laying it like this will stop any massive wastage of fabric. So where you can see the colouring, that's basically what we're going to take away. So just cut around the initial template of the now there is a fair amount of give in this because of the fact that this is cut on a bias. So when it comes to attaching around the sleeve, armhole, you will need to be slightly bit extra cautious on how you go about doing that. The armhole itself has to be fairly accurate, and I will actually show you what I will do with that armhole prior to connecting this sleeve to the armhole. I think I will dart the sleeve just to give it a better fit. So that is the churidar bazu, just a very long glove-like finish.